In this tutorial, we're going to show you a quick way in Webflow to create a back button using JavaScript. Let's dive in. Hi, I'm Kyle, the creator of No Code Collab, a site with tips, tricks, and tutorials for your next no code project. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and head over to our website where we've got snippets and other things to help you as you are implementing these solutions into your project. So sometimes you have a situation on your website where you want people to just go back one page. Maybe there are multiple ways to get to a page and you want to send people back the way they came. Or maybe you've got an e-commerce store or some way that people are filtering through a bunch of items, and so the URL is updating with those search criteria. And now when they go and look at one item and they go back, you don't want to have them rebuild all of those filters. So you want them to go back to the specific page that has the full URL with all of those filters in it. So we're going to show you a really simple piece of code that you can paste right into the button, and it will take users back one page. Okay, so here I am on a team page. We've got a bunch of different employees, and I've got different filters where I can filter these people by different by their department. And if I click in and I look at a page and then I want to go back, I want to go back to that same page, that same filter. And so that's what we're going to create, and it's really easy. So if we head over to Webflow, I've got my link. It's a link that I've dragged on the page. And when I set it up in my settings, I click the gear, all I have to do is put in this little snippet of code that says JavaScript history back minus one. So we're basically saying go back. Now, the key here as well is you need to have this little apostrophe at the beginning. Because if you don't have that, what Webflow is going to do is they're going to add the HTTPS :// backslash. They're going to add the whole thing. They're going to try to turn it into a link. By having the apostrophe, we keep that off of it. So go to No Code Collab, go to our tutorial. The link is in the description of the video. Copy this little code snippet, and then wherever you want to create that back button, you just put that into the URL, and that will send the user back one page in their JavaScript history. Hopefully that quick tutorial was helpful. Again, if you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and be sure to check out nocodecollab.com, where we have more tips, tricks, and tutorials for your next no code project.